Yeah, I'll fill it in, and then we'll go ahead and report over it.
Alright, I have a deck of cards. I want you to shuffle the cards. Shuffle them real well. I want you to take the cards and deal five on the left and five on the right, just like I do. Discard the rest, we don't need it. Look at the top card on the left and memorize it. Alright, place it back. Take the other pile, straighten it up, and place it on there. Right. Flip the whole deck over and lay one card, put one under. Lay one, put one under. Keep doing it. See it down to the last card. Okay. Put the deck in your left hand. Alright. Pick up the first card. See the deck of cards? I'm going to shuffle the cards. You do the same with your cards if you got some. If not, ask the next door neighbor for a deck of cards. Alright? Or make a deck of 52. Alright. Alright, you take the cards and deal out from left to right three piles of three cards. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Discard the rest, you don't need it. Alright? Now, once you pick, you choose any pile you want, just one pile. Alright? And stare at one card in particular. You stare at one card, and when you memorize that card, don't forget it. Straighten the cards up and take your pile and place it on one of the other piles. Doesn't matter. You take the other pile that's left and place it on top of it. Right? Now doing this from left to right again, that same manner. Now I want you to do, don't forget your cards, just flip them all face up. All face up. Now, spread the cards out on the table. Remember, whatever, whichever pile you see your card in, pick it up, and then you look at the middle card and concentrate, and that should be your card. Yes, that's your card. I guessed it right, the middle card.
Oh.
Yeah. Powerful mind reading trick. You gotta follow my instructions to a T. You take out the Queen of Spades and lay it down. You take out the Six of Hearts and lay it on top of it. You take the Jack of Clubs and lay it on top of it. You take the Three of Diamonds and lay it on top of it. Alright? Now you discard the rest. Alright? Now, you take the top card and flip it over. Then you cut the deck. You can cut it at three, you can cut it at two, you can cut it at one. Even cut. Now you take the two cards as one and flip it over. And you cut the deck again. Flip the entire deck over. Take two cards as one again. Flip it over. Now, what I want you to do is you cut the deck again. Now you have an option to cut again or stay there. Whatever it is, it's fine. If you can cut, I'll cut, but you don't have to cut again. Alright? Now, when you're ready, take the first one and flip it over. Take the second one and two as one and flip it over. You take the third one and flip it over. Now here's what the music comes in, David. I will flip it over. Now, there should be one card faced up amongst all the other cards. All the other cards will be face down, but your card will be faced up. When I spread it out, it should be your car. Don't tell me. I'm concentrating.
Do you know what it is?
Do you know what it is?
My name is David, and you may not see the table surface, but I'll do the best that I can, even though I sound like Mickey Mouse.
There. Here we go. We got the full deck here. Now, shuffle it thoroughly. Shuffle the full deck thoroughly. Of course, I'm not going to take the time to, because it just takes too long. I'll just do this. Now, you take and press your deck in three even piles. One, two, three. I'll show you. Three even piles. Now, you pick one of the piles. Either the first one, the second one, or the third one. And after you pick one, I'll pick this one. Take the other two and throw them away. Wrong way, literally, or your mom will get on your back. Now we have one deck. Pick it up. Now I want you to count how many cards there are. Second digit and add them up to get your answer. Like, I have 16 cards in my hand right now. So, I'm going to add the one, the first digit, to the last number, the six. And I get one plus six is seven. So, I'll take away the total, which is seven. One, two, three, four, 5, 6, and 7. And I take those and I put them away to the discard pile. Now, you may have a different total, so whatever your total is, take that number of cards from the top off and just put in the discard pile. Now, you have some cards left. Now you can put one in one. One on the left, one on the right, or two on the left, two on the right, three on the left, three on the right, four on the left, four on the right. It doesn't matter. Whatever your choice is, you can do it. But don't go over four. Now, I'm going to put mine down. All right. I chose two on the left and right. You do whatever you want. Now you take one pile, discard it, and you put it off to the side. Now you take the pile you have left on the table and look at the bottom card. Remember that card, not the top card, but the bottom card, which is this card right here for me. Now, yeah, I've remembered. Now I'm going to put it down
on top of the other pile. Now, I want you to take the top card and put it under. Now, I want you to do this 8 times. Put 8 cards underneath. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, hopefully, I believe the top card is the one that you've memorized. And if you take a peek, yes, I believe that's your card. Hit the red button. Red, not that button. Button on the side where the handle is. That.
My trick, will you follow my instructions to a T and it will work? This is a Copperfield trick. All the others were Max Mason. But, see, you have a choice between this card, this card, this card, this card. Choose one right now. All right, you choose one. All right, after you choose it, to make it more hard, I'm going to add more cards. Just to make it much harder. All right? Now, wherever your finger's at on that card, don't count that card, but count the next card. You can count, move 4 spaces, you go. Like if you
left, jump. Right, up, or down, but
left,
not vertical.
You go left, right, up, or down, or vertical, but not diagonally.
Diagonally, yeah.
And if your card's removed, you can't skip over that or skip any other cards. Just follow my instructions. For example, you chose suppose you chose 10 spades, all right? You don't count that, but you go like this in 4 spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or you can go 1, 2, 3, 4. There's many possibilities, but never go dying. Okay, you ready? You got your card. Move as I count. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh.
Alright, choose. You have a choice between the 8 of spades, the 5 of hearts, the 10 of spades, and the 4 of diamonds. 4 of diamonds was done on the train, but anyway. Hey! If you watch the Copperfield Special. But anyway, you choose one card, and I don't know which one you pick. Choose right now which one you want. You got it? Keep your finger there. To make it more harder, I'm going to add more cards. Alright, now. You can move up or down, side or side, sideways, up or down, vertically, but don't go diagonal. All right. Now, move as I count. You can go like this. Suppose you pick the 10 of spades. You can go, not counting that space. You move 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or you can go 1, 2, 3, 4. But remember, never move diagonally. All right. You ready? You got your card? All right. All right, move as I count. 1, 2, 3, 4. I know you're not at the 6 of clubs, so take it away. No humor to that. All right, remember, once the space has been moving, you cannot land on that spot. You can't jump over to the other side. All right, move 5 more times. Move as I count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll keep your finger there all the time until you get the last number I said. I know you're not at the 10 of spades, so take it away. All right, now move 2 more times. 1, 2. I know you're not at the 4 of diamonds. You can cough those stuff to the window with it. You're not at the 4 of diamonds. All right, now move 3 more times. 1, 2, 3. I know you're not the 7 of diamonds or the 10 of clubs. Now, move 3 more times. 1, 2, 3. Many of you were at the 5 of hearts, but I'll take it away. Now, you had a free choice through the whole time. Last time, move one. And keep your finger there. You're not at the three of diamonds. And you're not at the queen of clubs. You're at the ace of spades.
David, and I would like to show you a magic trick that I just created. Something David Copperfield did. Because you see, there's a predicted card that I've written, but some people think that that's impossible. And sometimes I make mistakes. Well, when the person usually picks it, it's usually not an ace. So I usually end up having to make it so that something does pop up. And I usually do, like this two. As you see, it's a two. Now I'll reach out of the drawing. Show you the card. Now, as you see,
like it to just right, look solid drawing. But what you don't know, I think I should show you. If I tilt it upward, you'll see there's a line from one corner to the other corner, and underneath there's a piece of cardboard underneath the paper. Underneath that, a crack. Hey, you see the crack? See the crack right here? See? That's the crack. Now, the card slides behind cardboard and slips up through the crack here. See? Now, when held at a certain angle and the sunlight cannot be seen, as you see, cannot be seen held like this. Nor can it be seen in a shadow. If you have a shadow, you have your shadow overcasting this, the shadow will hide the hole. Several different ways here. My theory is just one of the theories. There are many other ways. Imagination is very, very wise. And I believe anybody can make magic tricks, but it takes a special person to come up with the idea of how it works. As for now, that's all. This is about all I'm going to do now. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
market. Nice calculator. I even lost my deal. Keep your eye on his bird cage. Now you see it, now you don't. I think I'll go get another.
Thank you.
Here's, we're going to do some rope and scarf tricks. Okay, Tommy, David.
Thank you.
close-up, Maggie. First, I'll do mine first. All right, David Costco did this in China. I don't got a chopstick, but I got a pen. I improvise. All right, you can see the quarter. Okay, now, pen. Watch. Thank you.
happen when you try to help.
Well, it wouldn't bounce,
but it would pop.
Now, with the magic,
I'm going to make the needle go through the balloon. Thank you. come back to normal now. We can't leave it this way, because the man that owns it is making upset, so.
CIA agent, he just followed Billy all the way over to Copenhagen. And I play an officer who's walking down the street, and I run into the CIA agent, and I kind of help him out. But as the conversation is going, strange things happen.
Unless they get put it on me, unless I can get out. I mean, the war I have. What did you do that?
I bought a $500 camcorder. Real nice camcorder.
Nice.
Oh, we was good.
Americans are weird.
Talk about going to Denmark. Anyway, it's pretty nice out here.
What's that?
Check your pocket.
I'm loving this. I'm starting to suspect that he's in on this.
I'm going to put it in my top pocket. Change up a little bit. Change up a little more.
I swear, it's got to be him. I have a feeling it is.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, I think my wife should be here within 10 minutes.
All right. I still think he's up to something. You better keep an eye on him.
I am. Although,
if you like, I can call.
I'm tired.
He's chained up. He can't do nothing.
If you like, I can call Interpol for backup.
Call the Fallon Squad.
He has to be tried first.
By the way, I threw the key away.
Why?
I threw the key away.
You didn't?
I did.
Uh-oh. We're in trouble now. Yeah, yeah, sure.
Yeah, that was the last key.
Are you sure? Oh, boy. Now I'm in trouble. Now what's Mike up to now? over my thumb. Excuse me?
Huh.
Hope you this is the last show. I get over my thumb.
This will be up those
things. Mind me by a good poisonous thumb. Very funny.
Thank you.
I'll go back to the dugout man. Right. you did it?
I folded up.
Oh, that's no good.
Okay. Okay. Now, you guys picked out of nowhere. Through the ball. Alright. And you wasn't three digits, right? And I hit it with him, and he got rid of it. You did it fast. I don't want to see that, so that's it. I like the flash. Anyway. Okay, so I didn't look at it. I handed it to him, right? Okay. What was your three digits?
478.